it wasn't brilliant for the Mudville nine that day. The score stood 4-2 with but one inning more to play. And so when Cooney died at first and Burrows did the same, a sickly silence fell upon the patrons of the game. A straggling few got up to go in deep despair. The rest clung to that hope which springs eternal in the human breast. And they thought if only Chase they could but get a whack at that, we'd put up even money now with Casey at the back. But Flynn preceded Casey, as did also Jimmy Blake, and the former was a no-good and the latter was a fake. So upon that stricken multitude grim melancholy sat, for there seemed but little chance of Casey's getting to the back. But Flynn let drive a single to the wonderment of all, and Blake the much despised tore the cover off the ball. And when the dust had arisen and the men saw what had occurred, there was Blake a safe at second, and Flynn a hugging third. Then from 5,000 throats went up a lusty yell. It rumbled in the valley, it rattled in the dell, it knocked upon the mountain top and recoiled upon the flat for a Casey. Mighty Casey, who was advancing to the bat. There was pride in Casey's bearing as he stepped into his place. There was ease in Casey's manner and a smile on Casey's face. And when, responding to the cheers, he lightly doffed his hat, no stranger in the crowd could doubt.
Towards the Casey.
10,000 eyes were on him as he rubbed his hands with dirt. 10,000 hands applauded as he wiped them on his shirt. And when the writhing pitcher ground the ball into his hip, defiance gleamed in Casey's eye. A sneer curled Casey's lip. And now the leather-covered sphere comes whirling through the air. And Casey stood a-watching it in lofty grandeur there, close by the sturdy batsman the ball unheeded sped. That ain't my style, said Casey.
The right one,
the umpire said. Then from the benches, black with people, went up a muffled roar, like the beaten storm waves on a stern and distant shore.
Kill him! Kill the umpire!
Cried someone on the stand, and it's likely they'd have killed him had not Casey raised his hand. With a smile of Christian charity, great Casey's visage shone. He stilled the rising tumult. He bade the game go on. He signaled to the pitcher. Once more the steroid flew, but Casey still ignored it, and the umpire said,
right to! Hurrah! Cried the maddened thousands, and echo answered for all.
But one scornful look from Casey, and the multitude was awed. They saw his face grow stern and cold. They saw his muscles strain. And they knew that Casey wouldn't let that ball go by again. The smile is gone from Casey's face. His teeth are clenched in hate. He pounds with cruel violence his bat upon the plate. And now the pitcher holds the ball, and now he lets it go. And now the air is shattered by the force of Casey's blow. Somewhere in this favored land, the sun is shining bright. Somewhere bands are playing, and somewhere hearts are light. Somewhere men are laughing, and somewhere children shout. But there is no joy in Mudville. Mighty Casey has struck out.